Welcome to AE Valves, a worldwide leading manufacturer and innovative, robust, and tailor-made valves. Most of their products are engineered to order, just like this one we see they're working on right now. And today we'll see how Odoo 16 will help them improve their processes even more. On the bill of material overview, we can see what quantities can be produced and when. And when the customer agrees to the design and scheduled date, manufacturing orders will be triggered. So let's go to our manufacturing orders now. Here we have one for this product that is scheduled in 13 days. Let's go ahead and check this out. We see we don't have enough components available yet. If we check just below, we see that we do have some already available, some have been ordered, but not all of them yet. And once we have all of these components, we will be able to start production.
Thank you so much, Amy. Once the missing components have been ordered, they are stored here in our warehouse, in the various shelves that you can see here. Then, for each manufacturing order, products are pre-assembled as a kit and stored in the pallets over here. As a picker, I will see which picking job is next. To do that, I can simply use my barcode app on my mobile device and carry on the operations. So let's see what is next. All right, here I see that I have to go to shelf one and take one unit of an extended bonnet. So let's go for it. To confirm the location in which I am taking the component, all I have to do is scan the source location, move my product, confirm the fact that I have added it onto my pallet, and then finally, to say in which pallet it has arrived, simply scan the pallet barcode. Now I see that I have to go to shelf 2 and take 5 units of the packing rings. I will simply take 5 packing rings, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I confirm that I have taken them, and again, I will scan the pallet barcode to indicate that they have arrived in this pallet. And finally, I see that I have to go to shelf 3 and take 1 unit of the extended stem. I will scan the source location of shelf 3. I will take my product. I will confirm the number of units that I have moved, scan the pallet barcode, and validate my transfer. As the components are moved to the respective assembly line, that transfer can be validated at once. Once the pre-production pickings have been completed and the components are ready for assembly, Odoo automatically releases the associated work orders into the manufacturing execution system. With Odoo 16, it's possible to create dependencies between the different work orders of the same bill of material to optimize the planning even further. Here, there are 3 assembly lines. Those 3 assembly lines are depicted in my manufacturing execution system, as you can see. And here I work at assembly line 1. I see that there is a new work order to launch. Here I see that I have to manufacture 1 unit of the bonnet. I see that the work order is ready, so I can simply access it. When I access it, I can simply log in by selecting my name and entering my own personal PIN code. I am logged in into the work order. As you can see at the top right of the screen, you see my name and my avatar. With Odoo 16, it's also possible for several employees to log in into the same work order, and the times of the different employees will be considered for the final costing analysis of your product. Hello, Jonathan. Hi. So for instance, if he wanted to log in at the same time and help me with my assembly process, he would simply need to add a new operator into the process, as such, enter his own PIN code and validate. And as you can see, he's now logged in. Thank you, Jonathan.
You're welcome.
Now, let's carry on with the assembly process. I see on the left-hand side of my screen all of the different steps that I have to do. I can quickly glance at them before I start my work. And on the right, for each highlighted step, the specific instructions with the possibility to also add an image. I see that the first step is asking me to make sure that my work center is properly set up. Here, as you can see, everything seems to check out with the way it's supposed to be. To go on to the next step, I can simply interact with the tablet, or I can also use the devices that are connected to my tablet using the Odoo IoT box. So for instance, in this case, I will simply go on to the next step by hitting the pedal as such. As you can see, as soon as I do so, Odoo takes me to the next step. Over here, I see that I have another step to do. I have to make sure that the body of my valve is properly mounted into the foot as such. Over here, it seems to check out as well. If I want to go to the next step, I can also interact with the next button on the tablet directly. Over here, I am on to the third step, and this time I have a quality type instructions to do. I need to check that the diameter of my stem over here meets the quality standards. In order to do that, I'm going to use my vernier caliper to measure the reading. The measure is automatically transmitted onto my tablet and I can move on to the next step. Over here, I am now asked to register the lot number of the bonnet over here before I start the final assembly process. So here, I am just double checking that it's RT22A210. It checks out, so I can validate. I now have everything to complete my assembly. I see that there are two assembly steps and that the process starts with a ring assembly. In order to process that step, I see, thanks to the picture, that I have to put the bonnet in this position and mount the packing rings onto the bonnet as shown here in the picture. So this is done. I can simply pass my check. Now I see that I am onto the final assembly step and I can go on with the assembly. And so this time I need to take my stem and insert it into the bonnet. As such. This step seems to be validated and I can go on to the next one. So the next one asks me to take a picture. This time I can simply use the camera of my tablet over here. I can simply validate as such. Here I see that I am in the final step of my process. Before I do so, I would like to use a new feature of Odoo 16, which is to provide feedback to the engineering team about the way this product was assembled. When I was assembling the stem into the bonnet, a packing ring fell. I instantly came up with the idea of a more efficient way to build that product. So in order to do that, I can simply go to the step, and here, from the View More option, I can suggest to delete the step. If I want, I can add a comment, but let's just go without the comment for now. And I can suggest another step instead. And to do that, you have to go to the View More option again. You simply add a step over here, and you can start building a step just as if you were in the office. All right, and if I want, I can even take a picture of what I mean, just like we have done before. Again, I can simply access like that if you want to emphasize something. I can use this photo and propose the change. As you can see, my step was created over here. I can pre-visualize this step before I move on. It seems fine, my instructions seem clear, and the picture is fine as well. So I can simply validate that. And I am done, taken automatically onto the final step that I was supposed to complete before, when I am asked to generate a serial number for the final product and print a label. So let me first generate a serial number by clicking the plus symbol over here, and then go on, generate a new label. I am now done with the process. Odoo gives us a small work summary about what has been done. I also get a congratulations because I have done the best time of the month.
Here in the manufacturing engineering office, our job is to improve the manufacturing process. To do that, we use Odoo PLM, where we can perform product quality and instructional changes. And we've just received feedback from Mathieu after his latest operation. So let's check out the ECO. We're going to go to engineering changes, and we see the ECO created here for manufacturing order 43. And from here, we can see the product as well as the original bill of material. Now let's check out the operation changes. So he's proposing that we delete one of the original steps and add a new one. So let's first check out the step that he would like us to delete. So that's 6. We're going to go to the bill of material, operations, instructions. All right, I see which one he's talking about. Let's jump back to the ECO, and we're going to see what he would like to improve specifically. So I'm going to go to the next revision, go to the instructions, and here is number 19. I see assembly feedback, that's what he titled. So here he would like us to place the stem inside the bonnet before the packing ring. All right, that looks good. So let's change the title here. So I'm going to remove feedback, and I'm going to give it its original name, which is ring assembly. All right, great. Let's jump back to the ECO. Looks good, so we're going to validate this and apply our changes. And that's it. We've improved this process.